Wandering Jews. Mum is a good writer who travels the world and takes me with her because I'm her little girl. She transports me in a peekaboo bag on the plane, sedated I arrive at our destinations, feeling no pain. Iceland. Any Jews here? Living, really dying. In icy Boston, we read a newspaper ad, touting Reykjavik as a new late spring summer fad. We book Icelandic air. Kitties, you know, receive special fare. Soon upgraded to leather in first class, Mama's offered booties before she even asks. Once they're ensconced, I fall into a deep, no, happy trance. Upon landing, we wait to change our money. I hiss at anyone who pats my basket, dares to call me honey. To our amazement, no, our consternation, Iceland is a nation, not of greenery, but rather volcanic rock. Must say tourists are in for quite a shock. Around 1 a.m., we have such fun in this land of the midnight sun. Sampling soft salmon from a big plate, we eat ever so late, in the middle of June, sans even a gleam from a silvery moon. Mama knows a pianist here. She takes us for a late-night drive to view spouting geysers whose healing properties, we hear, have helped many people stay alive. Chilly and sipping tea from a flask, Mama suddenly has the gumption to ask, "Is there a large Jewish population here in this tiny nation?" "Don't be silly," responds our laughing host. "There isn't even half a Jew at the very most. There once was a cousin of a certain priest who had a Jewish relative somewhere back east. But there are no Jews now, so sorry. Hope you still enjoy our land without worry." The mist keeps curling. Night grows ever so cold. Mama draws near. Seems she's far from sold. "Ketzala, let's put our migration plans to Iceland forever on hold."